Please help support the channel by visiting our Amazon store, affiliate link below. The delayed Rotten Tomatoes score reveals where Justice League currently sits. Now, yesterday I talked about the leaked score, that it was sitting at 48% according to a supposed leaked Flickster image. Unless some new stuff has been added to the algorithm, it's not that. It says here 43% is where it sits. Justice League, it puts it ahead of Batman v Superman Dawn of Justice and Suicide Squad, 27% and 26% respectively, but still falls short of the shared universe's first film, Man of Steel, with the 55% or the 92% for Wonder Woman. And it says here that might have been setting the bar too high, but surely diehard fans of the DC slate of films wanted something something north of 50%. And this is again is the whole issue with Justice League and the DCEU and film critics and Rotten Tomatoes. There is clearly a bias there, in my opinion. There's clearly a bias. It's been this thing going on for years now where it does feel like the media for the movies, the movie bloggers, the reviewers have an implicit bias against DC. I'm not saying that that's not warranted to some extent. As much as I loved Man of Steel, it placing in the top five films for me in 2013, and as much as I enjoyed Batman v Superman, the extended cut, I can see why Batman v Superman got the score that it did for its theatrical. I think it should be revised based upon the extended cut, to be honest with you. You look at Suicide Squad and you go, look, I love Suicide Squad, but I can understand why people didn't like it. For me, it worked. For others, it didn't, and that's okay. But the box office return on that film was insanely high for the Rotten Tomatoes score that it got. Same with Batman v Superman. Now, I agree with El Mayambi when he said during his review of the extended cut that by cutting out that half hour of Batman v Superman, Warner Brothers did effectively leave about $250 million on the table. And I very much agree with that sentiment, simply because the extra half hour, well, that might have cut down on a screening. You know what? After that first week, you would have had more repeat viewings because it was a good movie. The third act still had issues, don't get me wrong, but ultimately the first two acts were solid. And as a result of that, I think people would have been way more friendly to it, way more inviting to it. And there was a reason why Batman v Superman, the extended cut, spent 5 weeks at number one of home video sales. 5 weeks that summer. So yes, people clearly liked the extended cut. People clearly enjoyed it just on home video, which while that was good for Warner's in terms of that particular market, it could have done far greater in terms of theatrical. And I feel like with Justice League cutting it down to 2 hours, once again, specifically cutting it down to 2 hours, is going to have that negative impact. And it goes to show you that somebody at Warner Brothers simply has their head up their butt, and unfortunately they're not going to learn. And I don't understand why the powers that be over there haven't realized this yet, right? But they probably looked at the success of Wonder Woman being, I think, just over 2 hours, and how people loved that movie. They thought they could maybe try to catch lightning in a bottle here. I got a message last night from a movie theater manager who's apparently a listener, and he was telling me to like watch out for the movie, that like there's the first couple scenes are very like pro SJW, and I'm like, I don't care about that going into these movies. But, you know, clearly there's people that are going into this watching it with the bias one way or another. And I do feel that when it comes to the debate between Marvel and DC, I do feel that people are wanting DC to fail. They love what Marvel's done. Marvel's been successful for 9 years, 17 movies. I mean, you know, over $5 billion in the worldwide box office for those films. And that's insane. But I think they look at DC as this underdog that can just never, ever, ever actually get himself to the point of where they'll look at it and go, it's on par. You always have to have a hero or a winner and a loser. And regardless of how good DC movies maybe eventually get, you're always going to have that bias, and that bias is always going to impact everything to do with the franchise. At least that's my opinion on it. So